we now discuss the solution of a problem from the section Linear Algebra, and this problem is on the orthonormal basis of the Euclidean space R power 4, and this question has appeared in CSIR National Eligibility Test held on 30th November 2020, and it is from the section C. The problem is, let the set consisting of y1, y2, y3, y4 be an orthonormal basis of R power 4. Which of the following are orthonormal bases? And we are given four options. Option 1, the set consisting of y1 plus y2, y1 minus y2, y3, y4. Option 2, the set consisting of y3, y4 minus y1, y2. Option 3, the set consisting of y1 plus y2 by 2, comma y1 minus y2 by 2, y3, y4. Option 4, 3y1 plus 4y2 whole by 5, 4y1 minus 3y2 by 5, y3, y4. Now, let's now review the definition of an inner product space and the norm and their properties. Let V be a vector space over a field F is either field of real numbers or complex numbers. A mapping that assigns an element bracket x comma y, now we will read it as bracket x comma y, of the field F for each ordered pair x comma y belongs to V cross V, such a mapping is called an inner product if it satisfies the following conditions, and these conditions are true for all x, y, z belongs to V and the scalar alpha belongs to the field F. Condition 1, bracket x comma x greater than or equal to 0 for all x belongs to V, and bracket x comma x is equal to 0, scalar 0, if and only if x is a 0 vector, and bracket x comma y is equal to the conjugate of the bracket y comma x when F is the field of complex numbers, and when F is the field of real numbers, it is symmetric. That is, the x comma y is equal to y comma x. And the third condition is bracket alpha x comma y is equal to alpha times bracket x comma y. And the fourth condition is x plus y comma z is equal to x comma z plus y comma z. And what is an inner product space? And a vector space together with the inner product defined on it is called the inner product space. Let us now consider the inner product space V. In that, let's take an element x belongs to V. Then we define the norm or the length of that vector as norm x is equal to the positive square root of the inner product of x with x. Now we call it as inner product. And in the definition of inner product, this will be called as the bracket x comma x. Now, norm of x is defined in terms of the inner product by norm x is equal to under the square root of the inner product of x with x. And it has the following properties. Property 1, norm of x greater than or equal to 0 for all x belongs to V, and the norm of x is 0 if and only if x is a 0 vector. The second condition is norm of alpha x is equal to mod alpha into norm x, x belongs to V, for all x belongs to V, alpha belongs to F. Agreed. And the third one is norm of x plus y is less than or equal to norm x plus norm y for all x, y belongs to V, and this is called the famous triangle inequality. Now let's get into the problem. Solution. Given the set consisting of y1, y2, y3, y4 is an orthonormal basis in the inner product space R power 4. What do you mean by that? It is a basis, means it is linearly independent, and every vector of R power 4 is uniquely written as a linear combination of y1, y2, y3, y4. That is, y1, y2, y3, y4 is basis, and is an orthogonal set. That means they are pairwise orthogonal. That is the inner product of any two distinct vectors is 0, and the norm of each vector is 1. So this means the inner product of yi comma yj is equal to 0 when I not equal to j. That means they are pairwise orthogonal, and norm yi is under the square root of the positive square root of the inner product of yi with yi is 1 for all I is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. So such a set is, such a basis is called an orthonormal basis. Now let us get into the statement that is given in option 1. We have to decide whether these statements that are given in options 1 to 4, whether they are orthonormal basis of R power 4 or not. So the first one we have taken here. Let us take the norm of the first vector, that is norm of y1 plus y2. So norm of y1 plus y2 square is equal to the inner product of y1 plus y2 with y1 plus y2. That is, the inner product of y1 plus y2 with y1 plus the inner product of y1 plus y2 with the second vector. We are using the property of the inner products. And now again, for this one, norm of y1 with y1 plus the inner product of y1 with y1 plus the inner product of y2 with y1 plus inner product of y1 with y2 plus the inner product of y2 with y2. So the inner product of y1 with y1 is norm y1 square, and it is norm y2 square. This is 0, this is 0, because they are orthogonal. So this is the one. And norm of y1 square is 1, norm of y2 square, this is y2 square, is 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, and the norm is root 2, therefore, and it is not equal to 1, therefore, this set given in option 1 is not an orthonormal basis. Therefore, the option 1 is not true. Let's get into the next option. The next option, what we have considered, is option 3. So now it is y1 plus y2 by 2 comma y1 minus y2 by 2 comma y3, y4. Is it an orthonormal basis for R power 4? Let us take the first vector, take its norm. Norm of that is equal to norm of alpha x is equal to mod alpha into norm of x. That is mod of 1 by 2 into norm of y1 plus y2. And mod of 1 by 2 is 1 by 2. And norm of y1 plus y2, what we have seen in option 1, it is root 2. It is a root 2. And that will be equal to 1 by root 2, which is not equal to 1. It is the norm of this vector is not 1. Therefore, these vectors given in this set is not an orthonormal set. So it is not an orthonormal basis for R power 4. So the option 3 is not true. Let's get into the next option. Option what we have left is 2. So we take it 2. In this statement, we have y2 is there, y3 is there, y4 is there. Instead of y1, we have a minus y1. Now, first we see whether this vector minus y1 is orthogonal to y2, y3, y4 or not. So, the inner product of y1, comma yj for j is equal to 2, 3, 4, it will be equal to the inner product of alpha x comma y is equal to alpha times the inner product of x with y. So that will be equal to minus 1 times the inner product of y1 with yj, and y1 is orthogonal to y2, y3, y4, therefore it is equal to 0. So thus the inner product of minus y1 with yj for j is equal to 2, 3, 4 is 0. Thus, the four elements are pairwise orthogonal. Now, what is the norm of minus y1? The norm of minus y1 is equal to mod alpha into norm y1, mod minus 1 into norm y1, norm y1 is 0, y1 is 1, sorry, that is equal to 1. Thus, the norm of each vector is 1. Therefore, this set given in option 2 is an orthonormal basis. Thus, the option 2 is true. Let's get into the fourth option. So, this is the set. We are given four vectors. And now, let's take the first one, 3y1 plus 4y2 by 5. And let's now take the inner product with y3 and y4. So, the inner product of 3y1 plus 4y2 by 5 comma yj is equal to alpha times 1 by y into 3y1 plus 4y2 comma yj, the inner product with yj. And that is equal to linearity we apply, 1 by 5 into 3 times the inner product y1 with yj plus 4 times the inner product of y2 with yj. And for j is equal to 3 to 4, y1, y3 are orthogonal, y1, y4 are orthogonal, similarly here, and this is 0. So 3y1 plus 4y2 by 5 is orthogonal to yj for j is equal to 3, 4. So orthogonality with this vector is true. So now let's take the inner product of the first one with the second one, and 1 by 5 will be out from the first one, 1 by 5 will be out from the second one, then it will be 1 by 5 into 5 into the inner product of 3y1 plus 4y2 with 4y1 minus 3y2, and use the linearity, 1 by 25 into 3 into 4 into y1 with y1 plus 3 into minus 3 into the inner part y1 with y2 plus 4 into 4 the inner product of y2 with y1, 4 plus 4 into minus 3 into the inner product of y2 with y2. So if you see this is 1 by 25 into 3 fourths are 12 into norm y1 square, and these are orthogonal, 0, and this is minus 12 into norm y2 square, and they cancel, and we'll get 0. So this is orthogonal to this vector. So this vector is orthogonal to 4y1 minus 3y2 by 5. So this is orthogonality condition. Now let us see what is the norm of this. So this is what we have done in the last slide. And let's now consider norm of 3y1 plus 4y2 by 5 square, norm square, that is equal to 1 by 5 square mod, of course mod 5 square is same as 1 by 5 square into norm of 3y1 plus 4y2 square, and that is equal to 1 by 25 into the inner product of 3y1 plus 4y2 with itself, 3y1 plus 4y2, expanding the inner product, 1 by 25 into 3 into 3 y1 with y1, 3 into 4 y1 with y2 plus 4 into 3 y2 with y1, 4 into 4 y2 with y2. So now this is 1 by 25 into 9 into norm y1 square, this is 0, this is 0 because they are orthogonal, and 16 times norm y2 square, and this is 9 plus 16 is 25, 1 by 25 into 25 is 1, so the norm of this is 1. Similarly this second vector is orthogonal to y3 y4, and the norm of this is 1, and this is orthogonal to the first one because the first one is orthogonal to the second one. So thus they are pairwise orthogonal, and the norm of each vector is 1. Therefore, it is an orthonormal basis. So the option 4 is true. So in all, the options 2 and 4 are true. That is our final answer. I hope that you have understood the solution of this problem and go on working out some more problems on orthonormal basis. And I wish you all the best. Thank you.